Well, hello and welcome to all of my wonderful grade three and four students. It's Mr. Bartlett here for another music lesson. So we're doing body percussion today. We've done this before. Some of you even started this lesson a week or two ago, before we went to remote learning. But you know what? You can do it again and you'll be even better at it. I've got an apology to make firstly. I'm not using my normal computer, which is my Mac, which I love. I've got to use a PC, which is really unfortunate. But anyway, can't help bad luck, guys. The sound is not very good. So, and sometimes the vision gets a bit funny. Try your best, guys, because it's all I can kind of use at the moment. So we'll get through, no doubt. Our learning intent today is we are learning to read symbols while using body percussion. And our success criteria, I can play beats and rhythms while reading symbols. Okay, so before we start our lesson, I'm going to show you a video that goes for just a couple of minutes. These guys are from America. They're young teenagers, I'd say around about year 9, 10, 11, something like that. And they've put a body percussion routine together. I've kind of used this as a bit of inspiration for you guys to maybe get together with mum and dad, nan and grandpa, uncles, aunties, whoever lives at your house, brothers and sisters. See if you can put a little body percussion routine together like these guys, because it's a lot of fun, guys, if you've got nothing to do. So I'm going to go into our PowerPoint, but you are not grade one and two. Let's get out of that one. Hang on. Get out of this one here. You are grade three and four. So what I want to do here is put myself up there again, and let's have a look at this. That's not where I want to go. Let's have a look at this clip right here. Hopefully there won't be any annoying ads. Let's see how we go, guys.
Voltaren Osteogel 12 hourly for a joint pain. Just that exercise.
Yeah, we can deal with that.
Two applications a day. Voltaren Osteogel 12 hourly gives you joint pain relief for the whole day and all night. Actually, exercise is not so bad. Voltaren, the joy of movement.
Nice puppy dog. So I'm sure you guys would agree that that was pretty cool. I really enjoyed that. So a little bit of inspiration for you guys at home. They had some movement happening as well, not just patting, clapping, but they were doing things like this. You saw what happened. So maybe even check out some other video clips on YouTube for body percussion. Let's get started, guys. So let's have a look at the first slide here. It's just two notes, and we're going to do some warm-ups using snapping, clapping, and patting. Won't do some stomping at this point. So this is going to be ta-ah, ta-ah. You know the musical syllables that we use. So let's start with snapping. One, two, three, four, ta-ah, ta-ah. Now clapping. One, two, three, four, ta-ah, ta-ah. And patting. One, two, three, four, ta-ah, ta-ah. Okay, so if we had a guitar or a keyboard or something like that, those sounds would obviously be longer. But when we're clapping or patting, we only hear them for a slight amount of time. Easy. Ta-ta-ta-ah. One, two, snap and go. Ta-ta-ta-ah. Clapping. One, two, ready, go. Ta-ta-ta-ah. And then patting. One, two, ready, go. Ta-ta-ta-ah. Easy. Next one. Couldn't be easier, guys. Have a look at that one. I don't even need to say anything about it. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay, nice warm up. All right, so that's all we need to do. I'm just going to scroll through. I've got a bunch of things to get through next week and the week after. As you can see, they get a bit trickier. All right, so we are going to do how many slides of these? Oh, we're going to do a few. And you've seen these before, guys. Some of you may not have. So it's fairly straightforward. We've got A, B, C, D. We do three claps and then we rest for the four count for A. Three stomps, rest for the fourth count for B. And then we've got rest, click. Sometimes I say click, sometimes I say snap. And then for D, pat, rest, pat, rest. Let's do each one once. Here we go. One, two, three, four. You can do the sh up against your lips. Just say it or just don't play anything. B, two, three, four. C, two, three, four. Sh. D, two, three, four. Couldn't be easier. All right. A. One, two, three, four. Shh. B, two, three, four. Shh. C, two, three, four. Shh. D, two, three, four. Shh. Easy. Okay, getting a bit trickier. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to speed up. Okay, we're going to go a little bit faster, but there will be a break in between each one. One, two, three, four. B, two, three, four. C, two, three, four. D, two, three, four. Okay, how are you going so far, guys? Excellent. All right. Now, going to mix it up a little bit now. Instead of having a break in between each one, we're going to go straight through. We're going to do A, then straight away B, then straight away C, then straight away D. Someone's really keen to get in touch with me. I'm just going to ignore them. Okay. It'll be clap, sh, clap, clap, sh, stomp. Stomp, click, click, etc. Okay, we won't go quite that fast. Here we go. So A, B, C, D, no break in between. One, two, three, four. Again, guys, if you're finding it difficult, and I've said this to you before, if you're finding it difficult to bring your finger up to your mouth, just do the shh or just nod your head in the time of that rest, okay? I'm sure you'll work out what to do. Okay, now it gets tricky. I might have to move myself down here. I'll put myself right over there. So now it gets a little bit trickier. We've got two claps here. signifying that we have TT. So this will be sh, TT, ta, ta. Down here, I'll move myself again. TT, sh, TT, sh. Okay, so you guys, again, have done stuff like this before, so you'll be fine. Let's do A. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sh, TT, ta, ta. B, 2, 3, 4. C, 2, 3, 4, T, T, sh, T, T, sh, and then I'll move myself here for D, if I can find my mouse, D, couldn't be simpler, four pats, let's do them really quickly, 1, 2, 3, 4, are you keeping up? Excellent. All right, now, I'm not sure what we've got next, I think we've got a couple of. Okay, so we don't need to do, oh yeah, so I will read that actually. In this body percussion unit, we are going to make the sounds of a drum kit using our feet and hands. Okay, so using our feet and hands, we're going to create the sounds of a drum kit. This is not beatboxing. This is body percussion emulating or copying the sounds of the drum kit, one of my favorite instruments. On the next slide, you'll see images of the drum kit parts, which include the hi-hats, snare drum, and bass drum, which we've spoken about before. So we've got our grid. You guys have seen these grids before, most of you, I think. All right. So the counts are down the bottom, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and not 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And you can see that here we have the bass drum, which is played with our foot on count 1 and count 3. The snare drum is on count 2. The hi-hats are also on count 2. Here, they're on 4. Here, oh, sorry, that's actually wrong, Mr. Bartlett. That's actually in the wrong spot. I've just realized my graphic is incorrect because the counts aren't lining up down here. The counts aren't lining up with the boxes. All right. And I think that's because I did this on my other computer and transferred it across to here. That sometimes happens. So I'm blaming my computer for that because I'm pretty sure it should be in the right spot. Anyway, doesn't matter. So guys, this is count 1. This is count 2. This is count 3. And this is count 4. Let's ignore this stuff down the bottom. Let's have a look at what it's going to look like. On the next slide, you'll see body percussion images representing the sounds. This is what it's going to look like in the slide, in the play along that we're going to do today. So clearly you can't do clapping and patting at the same time. So just choose one. This lesson is meant for a group of people, one group doing the bass drum, one group doing the snare drum, and one group doing the hi-hats. Okay. If you've got someone else there with you, maybe you can split the parts up or just do the bass drum and the hi-hats, or the bass drum and the snare drum. Okay, you'll get the hang of it. So that's what the symbols will look like. Let's look at the next one here. Again, these numbers aren't lining up. That's a bit annoying. That's count 1, that's count 2, that's count 3, that's count 4. All right, so we've got extra beats here on the hi-hats, and when you see it on the play along today, that's what it'll look like. Okay, so if you're doing the hi-hats, it'll be 2, 3, 4, clapping. 2, 3, 4. If you've chosen to do the snare drum, it'll be padding. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you've chosen the bass drum, it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? I think you guys get the hang of it. And then here we've got like that rock beat that I've played you guys on the drums before, the one that goes. So again, you would choose one of these instruments to play because you can't play them all at the same time. Same thing, bass drum is on count 1 and 3, snare drum is on count 2 and 4, but the hi-hats are 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Okay? And that's what the cymbals will look like. Easy. Let's do some warm-up exercises before we start. No, we're not going to do that this week. We're going to do that next week. All right, so what I need to do now is get to my song. And I'll just start it here, guys. one of my favorite artists, Michael Jackson. I just need to get to about here. So I'm just going to play it for a second. Don't worry about doing anything for the minute. Just have a look. Oh, you're done, Mr. Butler. Oh, go on to the next song. We do not want to do that. I don't know why it keeps on doing that. That's quite frustrating. No! It's a disaster. Hang on, guys. Bear with me. I will get this sorted. Maybe. All right. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to play the video. Here we go. That's what I'll do. Hopefully, that'll work. I'm not going to press it because it'll be a disaster again. So you saw across the screen the grids flashing to the beat. And then you saw... the foot, the pat, and the clap in certain spots. So whichever one you choose, and you can mix it up too, you know, in the chorus you might do the hi-hats, okay? In the verses you might do the bass drum, okay? So let's get going, and you'll get the hang of it. Next week we're doing another one. This is Young, Dumb, and Broke. I've got the wrong song again. Next week we're doing Young, Dumb, and Broke. But we'll do Billie Jean this week if I can actually find it again properly. Okay, so hang on, guys. I do apologize for this. All right. Let's play. You'll see the music scrolling, the beat scrolling across. I'm going to choose to start off with the snare drum. Okay, so it's the padding symbol in the middle, and I think it starts on count two or four. You guys choose whatever you want. Now I'm gonna clap. Hi-hats. Watch what happens in the chorus. Dance. Okay. Well, guys, we got through with a couple of little technical difficulties there. So I apologize for the sound. I have a feeling the sound really won't be that good, but I can't really do too much about that. We've got to work with what we've got. So it might have been a bit tricky to start off with, but as I said before, you know, you need to, that particular thing is done with three groups of people, and I would have allocated these people to bass drum, these people to snare drum, and these people to hi-hats. But I was kind of just changing the groups to show you what to do for each one. I hope you got the hang of it. I think you would have. Okay, hope you had fun, guys. Be good. Don't forget, keep singing, keep playing your instruments, and keep dancing. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.